Hello, everybody. Today is the day in 1980 when John Lennon was assassinated. Mark Chapman shot him, objecting, among other things, he said later, to the fact that Lennon had said the Beatles were more important than Jesus, and disputing the words of songs like Imagine. Mark Chapman, who was a psychotic, had a different vision for the world and shot Lennon, had plans to shoot other celebrities, and is now still in prison in Fort Worth. John Lennon, of course, known mostly for his music, but also for his political promotion of, among other things, peace. And you'll remember that he and Yoko Ono celebrated their honeymoon in Amsterdam in a bed, publicly using this, what they call a bed-in, to promote the cause of peace, particularly in Vietnam. The use of images like that to promote a cause is something that's really quite important, isn't it? The bed-in idea didn't really catch on and actually attracted quite a lot of ridicule. But rituals, some symbols connected with peace and other movements for change have really caught on. I mean, one of the earliest ones was the raised fist. 1966, it started with the Black Panther movement, the raised fist, which even Nelson Mandela used when he came out of prison. More recently, we've had in Hong Kong the use of umbrellas as a symbol of protest. It started, they were using umbrellas to protect themselves from the pepper spray that was being used to get rid of the crowds in Hong Kong, but then the umbrellas became a symbol of peace. Or even more recently in China, the use of a blank white piece of paper to indicate the way in which Chinese people are unable to say what they really are feeling and thinking. Such symbolic use of items, ordinary items, ordinary symbols, to enable a cause to catch on, are really important, and are always intrigued by the way in which these things emerge. Clearly, somebody has the idea to start with, and it grows. And I take my hat off to people who have that ability to encapsulate a movement, an idea, in one particular symbol. I think it's part of our human nature, isn't it, just to respond like that to a symbolic thing like a blank piece of paper or a raised fist. But today I just want to remember people who, in whatever way they think is best, protest and try and produce a more just society. The bed-in, not perhaps a brilliant idea, but it gained publicity because of who John Lennon and Yoko Ono were. And I take my hat off to celebrities who put their names behind causes which will lead to greater justice. But I take my hat off to everybody who, in whatever way and however small, and I play my part, and I expect you do too, in working for a better world, puts our effort and our thoughts, and if that's where we think, our prayers, into creating a world that's more full of harmony and peace. A bit like the way in which John Lennon's song Imagine hopes for and longs for.
I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. A brotherhood. Imagine all.